And who are really you, sir? You are not the director. Not an author. You are just an impostor. No, no drama, sir. You can't redeem yourself or change this situation. No entrance, no exit here for you too. Look at that people. They are happy now. Why? Because I giving them what you promise them. A story? A story with a big character. Where the character is a story, the story is a character, doesn't matter, sir. I'm trying to encourage you to tell us who is a big character here. Me? Not me. And who? No idea. Nevertheless, the answer is so easy. You're a kaleidoscopic genius. Doesn't suggest you anything, and you are even unavailable. To touch the evidence. I know your specialty to counterfeit and hide reality, but for once you can touch the truth. So, who is the big character here? You are the big character. A character so big to be perfectly able to manipulate all, everything, everybody, included those people. Those people that need you. To believe in something doesn't exist, and they become millions through that camera. Million of people manipulated by you. But your game has a problem. You can't see forms. forms, aspects. There are many forms to be. And you can see my form. So your control is not enough, but don't worry, you remain my big character. You remain an imposter. No, I am not insulting you. This is you, and not you. Observed by my eyes. Your author created you as an imposter. So you are an imposter for everybody. But be careful, I am not your invention as your property. Got it? And about those people, have pity of them. Never? You felt compassion? I see. You just put those people in the condition to spend their entire life to go nowhere. And they are so sickeningly attached to you. Can you imagine the consequences of all this? No consequences? So you too are blind. Yes, because you, instead to take my story from myself, and with my story my life, you give me a story. You give me a life, because beyond you, despite you, I clearly live now. And I feel you. Those people and their anger. Because you, they don't exist. I see all through this camera. Sir, the game is over. So let me breathe. Let me touch my freedom, or I totally unmask you. There is one of the most disgusting aspect a human being has. It is what you are doing now, sir. Yes. To use the grief of the people. No, sir. You are not confused. Never. Never you are. Can I go into details? You have deprived them from their identity, replacing their eyes through that camera that you totally own. And about me? Because you can't deprive myself from my identity, having me no identity. You try to capture my grief, the grief of no identity. It is clear enough. Your cruelty, sir, is able to cheat me, showing yourself to my eyes as my creator, my father, my mentor, my author. And you know, I came here desperately, hoping to find my altar. And for one instant, I believed you was my altar. And those people to be my audience. That camera put your vision out track my grief. My grief is not something that you can catch by spotlights or that camera. My grief is not to appear. Only people who desperately fight to be themselves can see my grief, can touch my grief, can feel it. Not you, not. My name is Nemo. That means nobody. But from tragedy. I saved my grief. You are free from this tragedy, trying you to be nobody. And immersed in this condition, immersed in this condition, trying to use my grief. Sir, the invisible moves the visible. The opposite is just an illusion where you like to be. Not me. Not me. You are immersed in a very difficult condition. And when you sometimes you bleed to suffer using the suffering of other people like me, it just a disgusting illusion of being, having you chosen to be nobody. And this is my worst grief, because put my solitude bigger, and this is your goal, that kills you. That while you are still there, your shadow is not you. Maybe because now the light is so strong that everything falls into the dark.